SQL injection. Ever wondered how to breach databases like a pro? In this video, we are delving deep into the world of advanced SQL injection techniques using tools like Ghauri. Imagine getting access to sensitive data, manipulating databases, and executing powerful queries. This is the art of digital infiltration. So, this is AmrSec, go get your coffee ready and let's dive in. Hold on, disclaimer. This video is only for educational purposes. Do not do this to anyone without their permission. Okay guys, so first what we're going to do is installing the tool that we're going to use. So just go to Google and search for Ghauri, GitHub, and hit enter. It's going to be the first result with you. And just scroll down here until you see the installation. So as you can see here, you have just to clone the repository and run the setup script. Okay, so here I'm going to just open my terminal and zoom for you a little bit and go to opt, or I will just clone it here because actually I have it installed before. So I will paste that here, give it a couple of seconds, cd like that, and ls. And as you can see here is setup.py. So what I'm going to do is simply type python 3 setup.py install and give it just a couple of seconds, and it's permission denied. So I will use the same command again but with sudo permissions. So as you can see, the tool is installed with us and it's ready to run. Just here type gh Ghauri and hit enter, and as you can see the tool is working with us. So what I'm going to do is open both Swagger Labs and see if the tool can find the SQL injection vulnerability there. Got it? So I will open that right here and see to solve the lab, perform a SQL injection attack to cause application display one and more. Okay, so I will just exit the lab right here. Let me just log in. Actually, I solved the demo before. So right here, here is the lab. If you take a look on the link, there is nothing interesting. Just scroll down, just view this product details, and here you will find the product with product ID equal 12. So that's what I have to do is come right here for the categories and just choose one of them. And as you can see, we have here where category equal gifts. So I will take that link and we will go to that tool right here and start by query. The usage is so simple. As you can see here, you have just to give it the URL and ask it what you want from this URL, like --dbs. It's going to dump all the databases for you, So I'll just -q and paste my link, and I will just see what's going to give me right now. I will zoom out a little bit and hit enter. As you can see here, it's telling me that category parameter might not be injectable, and here it's telling me that category it's injectable. So right here it's asking me to skip the other database builds. I will hit yes and give it just a couple of seconds and like that. So do you want to keep? Yep, I will. And as you can see here, Ghauri find a SQL injection in this parameter. As you can see here, it's giving you the payloads. So Ghauri found that category parameter is injectable. So what we have to do after that, right here, if you just type Ghauri like that, okay, maybe a first dash h, as you can see here all the usage of the tool. But actually, if you just come right here, you will find that you can dump the databases, and after that you can dump the tables from a specific database. So we're going to use like that Ghauri-u, and we will give it the link. After that, what we're going to do is type in --dbs for database. And actually what Ghauri right now trying to do is trying to dump all the databases from this injectable parameter. So here it's trying to find the database just with a couple of minutes, because actually this may be going to take some time. Okay, so as you can see right here, it's found information schema and BG catalog. This is two databases. I will just hit Control C right now, quit, and I want to show you one more thing here. If you try to see the usage of it, as you can see right here, here is to dump the tables. But if you want, here is to dump the databases, sorry. But if you want to dump the tables from a specific database, what you have to do just hit --D, and here you have to just mention the database that you want to dump the tables from. It in this example, we have here information schema. I will just hit Control C and Control V --tables right here, and if I just give it some time, it's going to dump all the tables for me. So right now I will just hit Control C. As you can see, guys, this tool is very powerful. But which is even more powerful is having the knowledge to all these in academic study. And this is what Arket Turkey specialized into. Arket Turkey can help you study all the engineering majors in the best universities in Turkey or Malaysia. And your degree will be certified over all the European Union and across all the world. They offering amazing offers on campus studies reaches up to 80% off. So just hit the link in the description so you can reach them and enjoy their free consultation right now. Back to the lab, actually you can just solve it by adding here or 1=1... and what this actually going to do, as you can see here, for the query is going to tell you select all from products where category equal gifts, whatever it is. But here if I try to add this all=1, is going to tell the database select all from products where category equal gifts or 1=1. So anything will be right here displayed. I will just hit enter right here, and as you can see, it's giving me all the products. So this actually is so simple. So right here, I'm going to go to the other lab right here, and let me see what's asking me for performance SQL injection. I have just to log in as administrator. I'm not going to use Ghauri for that, but let me show you how you can solve it. So simply right here, if you try to log in as administrator, just add this or 1=1... and what this actually doing is here is telling him login as user administrator, and this closes the query. And or 1=1 means or true, so it's just true. And here --- means comment was going to be after that. So here if you just try to type anything in the password and hit login, you can see your username right now is administrator and you solved the lab. So actually we don't need that right here. I'll go to the next lab, Oracle. So here in this lab, what it's asking me for is just displaying the database version. So I'll just hit access lab. Okay. And here we cannot see anything interesting, just the search. So here, if you just go to lifestyle category and see the link, you will find where category equal lifestyle. And yep, that's it. Control C, and I will just hit Control C here, Ghauri-U, and I will paste the link, hit enter, give it a couple of seconds, and as you can see here, it's found the payload, it's lifestyle. Actually, it's showed me too fast because actually I have tested it before. So with you, it's going to take a couple of seconds and it's going to be with you. Okay, so here I can just dump the database again and the tables, but I don't need that. If you just come right here to the solution, it's going to give you the specific query that that displayed the version, but it's not the main point right now. So I will close it and go to the other lab right here. So it's asking me to display the version right now again. So I will exit the lab right here and I will try to find any parameter that I can give it to Ghauri, or I have to do it manually. So as you can see, there is category again. So I'll just hit accessories and get that right here. And here I will ask Ghauri-U and paste that. Okay, sol-U and paste it and give it a couple of seconds. And as you can see, it's telling you that it might not be injectable. It's always telling you that, but right now it's telling you it's injectable. So I will just hit yes right here, skip the other payloads. And here Ghauri find that this link or this website have MySQL database. So it's right now testing. Okay, yep. And as you can see here, here is Boolean based blend payload and here is time based blend payload. Got it? So you can just right here type --DBS and it's going to dump with you the database right here. So give it just a couple of seconds. Okay. Okay. So as you can see here, it's trying to get the first database IN. It's mean information schema. We knew that. So I'll hit Control C and I will stop it. Quit. And let's see what we have in the other. So here you have just displayed the version of MySQL database using this query. So I'll just here close that and see what we have too. Have non-Oracle database. Okay. So right now here, it's loaded with us. And here I will use any category so I can get the parameter. And by the way, you will not always find it in the parameter. It's just the bot swigger labs. I don't know why it's the same parameter every time, but here just do the same, the issue, and give it the URL, and it's going to find it so fast. Okay, so you can just do the same using, okay, just let me open my SQL map. And actually SQL map will give you results too, but the problem in SQL map is giving you too much data that you don't need. Okay, so here I can just do SQL map dash u. It's actually the same usage, and hit enter. Yep, I want to use the same session. It's going to take a couple of seconds and give you the payload. Right now, as you can see here, it's trying to find the database. Okay, so as you can see here, it's telling you that the parameter category injectable with boolean based blind SQL injection. So let me see what SQL map did here. It's actually still testing the parameter. Okay, so let's see. And here for Oracle and MySQL, and here it's found it that it's using this database. And here if I hit yes, of course it's giving me the result here. And MySQL still sleeping, so I'll just hit Control C. The problem in MySQL, it just needs time, and actually in these days no one have time. So here, as you can see here, it's giving me the build. Okay, so I will not solve this lab. I will not just see the solution. I'll just close it right here, and let's see the other lab here, listing database contents on Oracle. Okay, so here I have to log in as administrator user to solve the lab. Why it's asking me that? Because actually it needs me to go to the database and dump all the users from database, and there I will find the administrator and username. I don't have to do all of that. I have just to find the SQL injection point using Ghauri. So here, let me get bits and right here, Ghauri dash u, take that, hit enter, give it a couple of seconds, and of course it's going to give you the payload for it, because actually it's 100% injectable. It's a lab. Yes, just give it a couple of minutes. Let's see, it's testing. Okay, do you want to keep testing the others? No, actually I don't want. And as you can see here, it's give you the boolean based blend SQL injection payload. Got it? Exactly right here. This small thing, got it? That's it. So here I will close that. I don't have to log in as administrator. I will get the other lab right here. And let's see. Okay. See, oh, okay. Onion attack. Okay. Whatever. Right here. Oh, I have solved with these labs. I don't remember that actually. So right here, let's see. If I search for accessories. Okay. This is just the accessories here. What if I hit here or 1=1 traditional payload and hit enter? Oh, come on. Okay, whatever. Right here, I'll get that. Gifts and Ghauri dash u best. Give it just a couple of seconds. And of course, it's going to tell me right now category is injectable, exactly like this one. So let me see. Yeah, of course. Okay, so okay, yep. And as you can see here is the payload. Right now if I just take all these labs and try to solve them for the SQL injection one by one, all of them will be solved with me. Of course, not all the websites you can just hack them using Ghauri, because actually SQL injection is not just in the parameters in the link. You can find SQL injection maybe in request. You can just inject some ID or parameter in some request, not all of them in the link. So actually, as you can see, Ghauri have too much tags to understand. It's not even that hard. It's very easy to understand, but actually I cannot cover it all in this video. So if you want to know more about Ghauri and the usage of it, check out the article link down in description to know more about it. In conclusion, mastering advanced SQL injection techniques using tools like Ghauri or SQL map can greatly enhance your penetration testing skills. However, it's crucial to use these techniques ethically and responsibly, and always test your methods in controlled environment. So actually, this is all I got for now. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below, or you can reach me directly using Twitter. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.